from Diddle Arena in Bowling Green, Kentucky, it's time for an afternoon of Sun Belt Conference basketball. It's the University of New Orleans against Western Kentucky. Two of the better teams in the Sun Belt Conference square off today in what ought to be a nice matchup. George Plaster and the coach, Clem Haskins, to bring you the play-by-play story. Clem, simply the reason for the good matchup, great guard play.
Great guard play, very exciting time tonight. I tell you what, both of these guards can really penetrate and take the ball to the basket. So it'll be an interesting matchup.
Now, under the category of how good is the guard play, let's start with Bold McCaleb. He is the fourth leading scorer in the nation, and Clem, he's got scouts here watching him like crazy.
We got a lot of scouts here watching him play, and also other scouts watching Courtney Lee if he haven't got a chance to play in the game tonight also.
Now, in Courtney Lee's absence, as many of you know, he's missed the last three games because of an ankle injury. Tyrone Brazelton has really stepped up.
Brazelton really stepped up for Western Kentucky University. Really doing a job for them, scoring points, penetrating, getting the ball, creating opportunities for other players as well as themselves.
Now, again today, we took a vote and asked everybody at Diddle Arena, do you want Clem's keys to the game? Clem, it was a close vote, but you've won out.
Well, I've won out again, but offensive rebounding for Western is really key to this game tonight. Also, they got to take care of the basketball. They're trying to win this game and staying out of foul trouble. They cannot get in foul trouble because these guards from New Orleans can put the ball on the floor and create opportunity by driving the ball to the basket. They really got to move their feet, stay down, and play good position defense tonight.
Now, let's take a look at the starting lineups very quickly. Of course, Bo McCaleb is the man at New Orleans. You're not going to totally stop him. I guess to quote somebody from ESPN, you can only hope to contain him.
That's correct. You know, tonight here, they just got to get down and move their feet and do a good job. It's a very good lineup, quick lineup, very explosive. And basically, all guards are playing at New Orleans.
And on Western side, they get Courtney Lee back. Ty Rogers has an ankle injury. We think he's going to go, but that we're not sure of, a guaranteed 100%. Should be a good ball game. Stay tuned. We'll have the opening tip-off coming up next on the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network and Fox College Sports. Well, we are just seconds away from the opening tip-off between New Orleans and Western Kentucky. Let's meet the two coaches who are involved in all this. Buzz Williams, his first year down in New Orleans, he's come off of Billy Gillespie's staff at Texas A&M. As you know, they have emerged as a basketball power. Darren Horn, he's in his fourth year here in Bowling Green, a former player at Western Kentucky, later on that Marquette staff that went to the Final Four about 4.5 years ago. The officials, Steve Wilmer, Tom O'Neill, and Tom Eads. And they will call the game today. Tom Eads, out of Central City, Kentucky, didn't know he would call this game until early this morning. He's a president of a bank in Central City, Kentucky, and a good guy and a very good official.
Well, that's a good pressure defense by the Topper to come out man-to-man there by Lee, and he wants to get on the board right away and take a jump shot, but he missed it. But a great defense play by Courtney Lee starting the ball game.
Boy, and you think for these folks here, it's not good to have Courtney Lee back. He's been out for the last three games with an ankle injury. They think they've got him back to where he's ready and raring to go.
Yes, you can see there, he's almost valuable to the team, just as valuable on the defense end as well as the offense on the, in the court for the Toppers.
Great guard matchups today. There's one of them. Ty Rogers on the baseline. 2-0 Western early.
That's a nice little 10-foot jump shot on the baseline with Ty Rogers. Good to see him get off the early start with that nice bucket. A nice curl off the baseline for a jump shot.
Clem, in Courtney Lee's absence, one of the things we learned is that Tyrone Brazelton is plenty good enough.
He's good enough. He really stepped up his game by scoring a lot of points and really creating opportunities for his teammates as well.
Well, they get Bo McCaleb very early on a palming call. He is the nation's fourth leading scorer at better than 26 per game, almost 30 per game in conference play, but he'll have to watch that. There's a steal by Reynolds, and Brazelton got him from behind to pick up the game's first foul.
They did a nice job there trapping in the corner, because Reynolds got over in the pass lane and intercepted that pass. That was a good defensive play by New Orleans.
Clem, you know a lot more about this in the scouting world and in the basketball world in general. What makes McCaleb so good?
Well, first of all, he can put the ball on the floor. He can drive the basket. He's blessed with great athletic ability. He's quick. He's strong.
And he just has a great instinct as a basketball player that you're born with.
He received a medical red shirt a little more than a year ago, suffered a bad wrist injury in a game down in Starkville against Mississippi State, so they're thrilled to have him back. His start has not been great, but trust me, he is every bit as good as advertised, and Western will have their hands full trying to stop him. And you know what? New Orleans will have their hands full as well.
Well, anytime you have a shooter like that get started, I tell you what, now he feels like that basket looked like a peach basket right now. It's big for him, meaning Rogers. He hit two in a row, well, three as well as a two. So that, I mean, that's a good sign for the Toppers.
Ty Rogers, who also deals with an ankle injury, and there Emerson came out a little too strong.
Well,
to
I tell
pick
you,
up his first.
I tell you what they tell you about Courtney Lee. He has been out now for 2 weeks, and tell you about he's a great offensive player, leading the Toppers in scoring and everything, but he put him on the best player. McCaleb's number one there. He's guarding him. He's the best offensive player, and one of the fourth leading scorers in the whole country. Courtney Lee's guarding him today. I tell you about the Toppers and they think about his defense.
It's also the sign that they're pretty sure ankle-wise he can do it.
That he can do it. That's right.
New Orleans has been shut out for a little more than 2 minutes. All of that ended with McCaleb out of the corner, his first tray of the game. Brazelton, good drive to the bucket. Emerson cleans it up inside.
Well, that's a good offensive rebound there by Emerson. He got inside the man there and really muscled way back for 2 points. That's a good sign for the Toppers.
Emerson coming off a big 9-point, 10-rebound game a couple of nights ago in Little Rock. You get 10 rebounds in a college game, you've done something very good.
That's correct.
Boy, look at McCaleb, and then look at the block by Jeremy Evans.
That was a great weak side help by Evans there. He got over time for the block. Just excellent defense rotation by the Toppers.
The offensive foul is on Suleiman. And that's the first foul of the game against New Orleans.
You can see Evans came over there on a high on the replay there for the block.
Boy, Rogers made a great play to save it. And then I think it was Brazelton that stepped in with a teammate in distress and took the timeout.
That was a good timeout.
You get a look at Darren Horn and his team. They're coming off a tough loss down in Little Rock on Thursday night. Clem, I want to go through this again. They played three games now without Courtney Lee, and certainly they didn't want to go through that. But will they be a better basketball team for having had to deal with that?
Without a doubt. It's going to give, you know, get the bench a chance to play. Guys like A.J. Slaughter will be back in this game in a few minutes, get some quality minutes. As you can see here, boy, this young man, McCaleb, can really stick it. He's hit a big 3-year. This guy's the fourth leading scorer in the country. So the fans out there tonight are going to get a chance to see this young man play because he's really one of the premier scorers in the country. He hit a 3 here, but later on you're going to see him take it to the basket. He also, at this stage, has shot over 120-some free throws. That tell you he's driving the ball to the basket. He's not only shooting outside jump shot, but they put it on the floor and create opportunity off the drive, too.
They've been taking a look at that three-pointer, and it appears that it's going to stick for McCaleb. So it's 7-3 early. Western, about 3 minutes into the game.
One thing about here, we have the, if I considered of calling the game, I tell you what, we got three excellent officials today. You know, Steve Wellman and Tom O'Neill and Tom Eve today. That's three of the best fishing in the country today. They're three great fishers.
Now, Wilmer is one of your Big Ten guys, isn't he?
He's a Big Ten guy, as well as Tom O'Neill. Those guys I've watched and worked a lot, and we've had our run-in over the years, but I tell you, if I was going to coach a game, I'd soon have these three guys, any three in the country, calling the game.
The third of those we mentioned earlier, Tom Eads, with the Final Four experience, so this is a very good crew that's been put together on a Sunday. And that foul is on, I think, Courtney Lee, and it is Lee, and it's his first. And Clem, that's one of the keys. If you play a game on Sunday, you've got a much larger pool of officials that are available.
That's true. You know, we had an accident, one official couldn't get here, Tom was available. So, you know, he wound up getting a quality official by having this game on Sunday afternoon.
McCaleb, also a very good passer, and all of that set up the jumper by McNeely, and then Emerson A little too aggressive. You can't do that.
You want to do that. That's one of the sins in basketball. You don't want to foul a jump shooter, particularly from a three. You do not want to foul from three-point range, particularly a big guy come out and whack a guy and give him a three-point shot.
Daniel picks up two fouls in the first 3.5 minutes and may have to sit here. McNeely is out of Toronto, Ontario, and if you look down their roster, they are a United Nations when it comes to where they have gotten their players. They've got a couple of kids out of New Orleans, but then they've got some Toronto, Tacoma, two players from Philly, a Phoenix, Arizona, African Republic, Tallahassee, Florida, Saragossa, Spain. What kind of budget did it take to get that done?
Well, I tell you what, they got a wonderful budget, but they got some great recruiters to be able to move around and get guys like that. So it's credit to their program to have those kind of coaches go out and find players like that.
McNeely hit 2 out of 3 to cut the lead down to 2. That's Butch Joyner who just checked in. That's a great feed.
Well, I tell you what, that was a great feed. It was a great cut by Brazelton. That's a great backdoor cut. That's just a great basketball play on their part. Being overplayed, defense man did a good job, got a position, great backdoor cut.
Very unselfish play. McCaleb from the baseline.
This young man, we tell him, he's everything we've been talking about. If he can put it on the floor and drive it and pull up a two jump shot, he's a handful.
He is not a one-man team. There are a couple of other players. Harlow in double figures at 14. They've got some players. They're a pretty good basketball team.
This is a very good team, you know, much better than the record indicates. They're 3-1 on the road, though. They only lost one road game. So you can tell you they can win on the road. The game they lost, only lost by 2 points.
That one went over the backboard. First time out of the game, a little more than 4 minutes in. Western the 2-point lead on the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network and Fox College Sports. Well, some of the crazies are out here on Championship Sunday. Western Kentucky, the early 2-point lead. By the way, not a whole lot of folks in New Orleans paying attention to this, if you know what I mean, given the fact that the Saints are playing the Bears in the NFC title game. Tyrone Brazelton's got other things going, though, Coach.
Yeah, that was a nice read there on the defense, man. Overplayed him, and a nice back cut there, and Jonah found him on a nice back cut.
I am very impressed with that young man. When Courtney Lee got hurt at crunch time, I saw him take over 2 or 3 different games. I was very impressed.
Very impressed with him. Now, Western's come out in a 1-3-1 half-court defense here, trying to change things here on New Orleans.
On the UNO side, it's still get it to number one. There he is in the corner. He can put it on the floor.
Well, that's what you don't want him to do against his own. He drove, he split the defense and drove right to the bucket. And I tell you what, he's a handful. He's really tough, but that's something you try to contain when he's driving through the zone, like shots like that.
Butch Joyner out of the corner. Missed on, boy, Evans. Ooh. Way up to snatch the rebound. That leaves Lee open, and the backside rebound comes to Parlow. Here's McCaleb again.
Nice
way
block
short.
There.
That was excellent defense.
Had good defense on Lee's part and blocked the shot there.
Lee is open. Boy, that one wouldn't go either.
But you know, it's going to take him some time. He's been off for 2 weeks. He's a little bit stale. His leg's not where he used to be, and it takes some time to get that feel back in the rhythm.
New Orleans with a chance to take their first lead of the game. Shot clock is down to 15. And this is normally where they give it to McCaleb and just everybody gets out of the way and lets him go to work.
Well, I tell you what, Reynolds can do the same thing, though. He can put it on the floor and drive, too. But that time he gets in trouble and he knocked the ball loose and got a jump ball.
Possession arrow goes to the Hilltoppers. A.J. Slaughter coming off a nice 14-point game in Little Rock is in for Darren Horn's team. So is Orlando Mendez Valdez, who wears number 20.
And Siakam's in the game now, too. The energy level pick up with his intensity. Siakam plays with a lot of intensity, plays hard, and really excellent rebounder.
Clem, we have Ashronge Suleiman in the game for New Orleans. And before the game is over, I'm going to ask you to spell both the first and the last name.
Okay, but I'm gonna
we'll let you buy a vowel.
Buy a vowel, okay. I need about two or three to
you
get that.
You may need about five when you see this. Orlando, let's fly and hit just inside the three-point line.
Nice little pick there by Brazen, set him up, came off of a jump shot here. They fall back into 1-3-1 zone, half court.
Orlando's playing pretty good basketball, isn't
excellent
it?
Basketball off the bench. He's doing a wonderful job for the top so far.
Watch New Orleans on the attack. Whatever defensively Western does, it'll always be shaded toward McCaleb.
They have to. They got to keep an eye on him at all time. He's really a threat out there. And also, you got Reynolds. He can really put the ball on the floor and create opportunities for himself and get in the lane and create problems for you, too.
New Orleans at 5-3 in the conference. And so, as we said in the open, two of the better teams in this league. They met a year ago in the Sun Belt Conference quarterfinals in Murfreesboro. Western won that one easily.
You can see there what I'm talking about. I'll tell you what, Reynolds can really take the ball and blow by if you're not careful, too. He plays a lot like Bridgerton, excuse me.
Sean Reynolds, first field goal of the game, and we're tied at 11. Joyner, good look to Slaughter, but an even better rejection by Suleiman. It'll go to the Privateers.
That was a... Siakam being a little aggressive that time. They call a foul on him. He tried to knock the ball loose, went over the top of the young man. They call a foul, but he's a very aggressive player.
Into the game for New Orleans, Dusty Driggs out of Sharpsville, Indiana, which almost guarantees he's a good three-point shooter.
He can shoot the three. You got to keep a hand on him. Hand up on him at all times. But he's a guy who can knock the threes down.
7.5 minutes in, and we're tied at 11. Carlo coming off a big game a couple of nights ago against Troy, where he was 6 of 6 from three-point land. There he is, make it 7 for 7.
7 for 7, I tell you what, Carlo did a nice job getting out, getting squared up and knocking that down.
Call us when you miss one. Joyner really never had a handle on the ball. Called for traveling. Give it back to the visitors.
Like I said before, this team is really capable of playing well on the road. Like I said, they're 3-1 in the conference on the road. They've only lost one game by 2 points and lose Anna Monroe on the road. And that game could have went either way at the buzzer. So, you know, this team could be very easy 4-0 on the road in the conference.
They play for the moment without McCaleb. Reynolds. Shot clock inside of 10. Parlow again, not this time. Good defense, and Brazelton there to clear the miss. This is A.J. Slaughter. Oh, was Brazelton quick or what?
Boy, he's good there. I tell you why. He's been beating him the last 4 or 5 games. You're right. He takes over. Once he gets there, he's a nightmare coming down the lane.
Now, when you sit where we are, right at courtside, and see the move he just put on, that's scary. You talk about some quicks. McNeely from 15. And here comes Brazelton. They back off of him a little, and that's what the quickness will do. They backed off just enough, Clem, where he could get off the three.
Just enough so he could clear some space. You know, he faked like he's going to the bucket, and he backed off and pulled back with a nice jump shot there and square up the three to for a three-pointer.
And on the other end, we have an offensive foul, and we also have a timeout. It'll be Western's ball when we come back. Hilltoppers lead it by 2. Well, they may have to send Buzz Williams a bill. Look at that. He is diagramming a play on the floor. And I guess you send the bill care of University of New Orleans. Now, on to more important things. Clem, before we went to the break, I was raving about Tyrone Brazelton on that play, which, watch here, they back off because of the speed. It leaves him the open three.
That's correct. You know, when you have a guy with tremendous quickness and speed like that, you got to give up something. He went to the bucket before that, and at that time, he gave him an opportunity to back up and shoot a nice three. So that quickness and that speed gave him an opportunity to get that three off.
Tyrone already with 7 points, and if history repeats itself, it'll be the fifth game in a row that he hits double figures. Mike Walker in the game. He has the ball at the moment. Slaughter is open. Yes. A.J. Slaughter with a long tray.
You know, he really is coming off a big game. His last game, they got beat, but he had big 14 points, so his confidence should be pretty high. He squared up and made a nice jump shot that time. He's a very good offensive player.
Western has scored 8 in a row, and here at the midway mark of the first half, they're up by 3. McCaleb with kind of a wild shot that did not draw iron. Courtney Lee misses again, but let me tell you, he will get it going.
He's just a little rusty in starting this ball game. Like I said, he's been out now for 2 weeks plus and missed last 3 ball games, and those shots will start falling for him.
McNeely with a soft touch. His 4th point to close the lead down to 1. Mendez Valdez tried to get it down low. Somebody touched it. It'll be Western's ball. Western 50-50 on the long ball in New Orleans. 2 of 2 early. This is Boris Siakam, and Siakam changed his pivot foot and they caught it. The turnover is number 4 on Western Kentucky. Good steal. Oh, and a beautiful second part of the play by Orlando Mendez Valdez. That's just great hustle.
He made great hustle, made a great anticipation on the play of the ball, and also able to react and throw it off the defensive player to get the turnover. Great play. Great defensive play.
Lee. That'll kind of get him going a little bit. Courtney Lee's first bucket, certainly not his last, comes at the 8:55 mark. And we have a whistle. An official way down on the other side of the court spotted something, and he spotted Ty Rogers with his first.
He went to go long at time. Rogers and grabbed him. Keep him going long in that situation, that run out. Topper coming out, flying full court pressure, man-to-man defense here. With Siakam going to do a little run and jump here.
McNeely just did get it to Reynolds, who goes coast to coast for the finish.
I tell you what, you open up the court on Reynolds, you're in trouble. I tell you, him and Caleb can really get the ball to the iron, so you really got to be careful. Open the court up on those two guys.
Mendez Valdez with the penetration. Walker will go to the line.
Well, that was a big-time rebound for Walker there. He really extended himself there and rebounded the ball and just almost had an offensive rebound and a field goal to go with it. Great, great hustle on his part.
Carlo's first. Only the 3rd team foul against New Orleans.
See, he extended himself there and really did a nice job. Almost got the ball in the bucket for a field goal and a free throw attempt, but he got fouled on the shot anyway.
Walker out of Macon, Georgia. Young man that, as the season goes along, will have a bigger role. 2 free throws. Western's lead is 5. Here's McCaleb. Pretty good ball movement right there. And McNeely got fouled on the jump shot. They got Courtney Lee, and that's his 2nd. So they got to be very careful here. Clem, that he does not pick up the third before the half.
That's correct. I think Coach going to pull him out at the present time here because he's an aggressive player. He won't back off, and he could pick up a third foul. 8 minutes ago, that's a lot of time in his half and a lot of time in the basketball game.
McNeely out of Toronto. And he misses the first free throw. Tyrone Brazelton back in. Courtney Lee will sit with his two fouls. More importantly, on Courtney Lee, whether the points come today or not, just from here, certainly not a doctor, he looks like he's moving very well.
He's moving extremely well. For a guy been out 2 weeks, he's not showing any favor. He's in the ankle and everything, and so, you know, it really looks good. I'll tell you what.
Walker was up there a ways and then got it rejected. Here comes McCaleb. He got fouled, and he'll head to the line. Boy, he is quick turning
he's
the corner.
He's quick, and he can turn that corner. You can see him get the ball to the iron, they say. I tell you, that's quick.
Who do you think of when you see him play? I want you to think about that. I'm going to toss a name out when we come back. 7:53 to play in the first half. Home folks, the four-point lead. Four-point Western lead at the 7:53 mark of the first half. Clem, we have bragged all along about Courtney Lee, Bo McCaleb, Tyrone Brazelton. We've got three of the best players in this league on stage today.
Three outstanding athletes, outstanding quickness, and they all can take that basketball and drive high in. They're very explosive with the ball.
McCaleb hits on one out of two. I asked you during the break to come up with somebody that you think McCaleb reminds you of a little bit. I had one in mind that I tossed out at you as Brazelton bombs away. He's got 10 early. Looks like he's off to a monster game. Allen Iverson was the one I thought of.
He's a lot like that. He's very explosive like Ivan. He can take the ball to the basket and also shoot the jumper on him. He's kind of reminding you a lot of him.
There's a little more to this Iverson thing here in just a minute. Shot clock's down to 10, and McNeely being hawked by Walker. That was great defense. Walker caused all of that.
He caused all of it. He stayed down in his defense stance. He did not get up, let the man drive past him. A lot of time a big guy get up, they want to reach, and a guy go around him. He did an excellent job of playing good fundamental defense.
So you tried to get Iverson to go to Minnesota?
Oh, without a doubt. I recruited him hard. Yes, yes. He's up there, and he's...
Slaughter called for carrying the basketball. This crew watching that very closely. And you told me he was as good at football and baseball as hoops?
That's right. He could be in NFL football, or could be in Major League Baseball. He could play all three sports. He's a tremendous player. All three sports. Great, great player.
And now he's a Denver Nugget. McCaleb with a crossover that was wicked, and that set up the jumper for Reynolds. Sean Reynolds has 7, and the lead is down to 6. Actually, the lead's down to 3. My math wasn't very good there. In fact, it was horrible.
This team is doing an excellent job of finding each other. You know, they're really playing well together. Reynolds and McCaleb, as well as Parlow, they all do a good job of penetrating, and they spot up and they find each other. They're really playing good, good team ball. I'm sure the coach is proud of them.
Buzz Williams, you can see him right behind the goal with his arms crossed off that Texas A&M staff that has been really kind of shaking people up in college basketball. A&M never considered a power, and all of a sudden the last 2 years they've gotten it done. He got the job off of their NCAA tournament appearance a year ago. Buzz Williams, first season there.
I tell you what, so far he's off to a great start and a great job. I tell you, this team here is a tough team. It's going to be a dogfight the whole ball game. It's well coached and good players. And now two good teams, good two coaches like this playing each other, and good players. It's going to be an interesting ball game.
McCaleb with the good touch. I'll tell you what, he can play. He's got 10 early, and New Orleans is back within one. Slaughter tough baseline jumper. And I say tough because it's hard from 5 to 8 feet to shoot that thing naturally.
Naturally, I tell you what, they don't shoot that shot enough. They want dunk or to shoot the three. So in between game, it's really long. It's lost, a lost arc. So that was a nice jump shot, him pull up and shoot that little 6-7 foot jump shot.
McNeely, good touch again. Boy, he got a nice roll for his 7th point. And Darren Horn is going to take a timeout. It'll come with 5:26 to play in the first half.
That was a good timeout here. Just kind of reorganize yourself here, particularly on the defense in the court here, because they got to do a much better job of containing the dribbler. They just really drive by him, penetrating, getting the easy shot here.
You know, we've done all this talking about McCaleb and how good he is, and obviously if you're averaging 26 a game, you're pretty darn good. How hard is it to play with somebody like that who dominates the ball and dominates all the shots?
Well, you see, you think he dominates, but I tell you, he's a really a good team player. You see, everyone else, you know, Parlow out there getting a chance to get the ball, McNeely, as well as Reynolds, they all get a chance. They're all averaging double figures. They have 4 guys that have been double figures, so he's doing a good job of distributing the basketball. He's passing the ball. He's giving it up. But he's just such a dominating player. When he gets it, he can score, but he also gives the ball up, too. So he's a very unselfish player.
Courtney Lee, there he is. Brazelton and McCaleb, I'll argue 3 of the 10 best players in the league. We know Lee and McCaleb are 1-2 in whatever form or fashion you so desire. That foul, by the way, against Parlow, and that's his 2nd. Only 14 fouls against UNO.
They're doing a good job on defense. They're not fouling a lot. They're staying down, moving their feet, not reaching and grabbing. They're just playing good position defense. That's what you ask for as a coach.
Walker gave Brazelton the high screen. That time, Tyrone's using the glass didn't help him, but Rogers has it tapped. Lee goes down, and everybody holds their breath, saying, is he okay?
But I tell you what, Walker made it possible. Walker's really changed his game. He's been the valuable player, most valuable player so far for the Tops coming off the bench. He's got about 3 or 4 offensive rebounds, or he's keeping the ball alive so someone else can get it. So Walker's really made a difference here in the last 4 or 5 minutes in the ball game. This is the offensive rebound alone, and plus his great defense pressure.
Before Courtney Lee got hurt, he scored in double figures in all 14 games that he played before the injury. He has been a model of consistency, not only this year. Let's face it, all along, this guy's a player.
This guy's a big-time player, you know. It's just unfortunate he gets hurt because that's part of sports. You know, guys do get hurt. That's Walker again off the offensive board. And he has a chance to get this bite. But he gets a nice friendly bounce there.
Courtney got a 3-point play, not normally the way you draw it up, but he'll take it. Either way, UNO will now take a timeout, down 4.
But you know, the Walker, the guy again, deserved to get one of those 2 points because he kept the ball alive to give him opportunity for the offensive rebound so Lee could make that shot.
So Clem, on Western side, they've played the last 2-3 weeks for the most part without Courtney Lee. How different a team is this for having gone through that?
Well, I'll tell you what, I think it's paying dividends now. You see Walker. Walker got some quality minutes, and it's proven now that he got a chance to play. And you see him playing with a lot of confidence here. Without Courtney Lee being hurt, he probably got the minutes he was getting. So now he's playing and doing a super job here of helping the Toppers here tonight. And that's going to help him down the stretch. You got guys like A.J. Slaughter, got a lot more minutes. It's going to help him. So, you know, those two players, they're going to really benefit by Courtney being out.
Buzz Williams headed to the water cooler. Whatever he said may have gotten the steam going a little bit. I don't know that. Just speculating. That time, Western's defense causing McNeely to throw it high and wide, and that is UNO's 9th turnover.
That was a good half-court pressure defense there, forced that turnover.
High screen from Walker. Lee the outlet. Now Brazelton will reset. Shot clock's down to 10. So whatever they're going to do, they're going to do it now. And whatever they did worked beautifully.
I tell you, Brazelton really shooting a three tonight. That's about three threes I believe he's made tonight. And they're backing up off of him because they know he can drive the ball to basket. So his drive is really giving him opportunity to get some threes, look from the three. That was a great three-pointer there.
This is Western's biggest lead at 7. And referee Tom O'Neill spotting a holding call. Not a 10-yard penalty, at least not for this New Orleans team. Timeout with 3:38 to play. First half, a little football in the mix. Western leading by 7. Well, part of the cheerleading crew here at Western Kentucky, and they're happy right now. Their Hilltoppers up 7. Clem, you talked about it a couple of moments ago during the telecast. You can see the confidence growing in Tyrone Brazelton.
Without a doubt, he's playing excellent basketball, as you can see now. With his great quickness and way to penetrate the ball to the basket, it gives him opportunity to get some of those good looks, but he had to back off and give up something. And that time he got behind, the young man went behind the screen, he pulled up and shot a nice three.
Western's work on the glass, you could argue, the difference in this game. And their bench has certainly done the job. Orlando Mendez Valdez, a big contributor. Mike Walker has done very well. Reynolds.
Mike Walker's really been the key, though. You know, he's given 3 offensive rebounds, but boy, he's kept the ball alive. He's probably got another 4 or 5 touches off there to keep the ball alive on the offensive board to keep the tops in the game.
Sean Reynolds out of Little Rock hits a pair. He has 9 points. Good 1-2 punch between he and McCaleb. Privateers back within 5. Walker nearly lost it. Lee recovers. Had that one swatted away. McCaleb ahead against Mendez Valdez.
You know, the guys like that, he was going full speed, was able to stop on a dime and square up and make a nice 2-foot jump shot, later soft over the rim. That's what that great quickness speed would give you right there. Here's a good drive by Mendez Valdez there and tip here. And great follow-up by Evans.
Evans, a chance at a 3-point play and a good piece of hustle to keep it alive. McNeely will pick up his first foul.
Well, Evans, great reach there. He gets the offense rebound. He keeps it alive. He missed 1 or 2 times, but I tell you, just that great reach of his. Able to stay up, keep the ball high, and follow up for a nice bucket. Chance for a 3-point play.
Evans' first 3 points of the game. T.J. Slaughter will come in for Western Kentucky. And out will go Ty Rogers. Western doing a lot of changing of defenses in this game. Showing you a little bit of man-to-man. Zone out of the corner, McCaleb.
McCaleb steps out deep. As far as deep as you can go on the corner, hit a 3 that time. I tell you, this young man has a total package offensively.
If he had taken one more step, he would have been sitting in the manager's lap. He's got 15, by the way, to get them back within 3.
That is deep as you can shoot out of the corner. I'm telling you, he really, really, they've been telling us he can drive it to the basket, but he's shooting a 3 tonight a lot better than I thought he could. So he's extremely popping outside.
Clem, when you play them, are you just accepting the fact that he's going to get 25, 30, let's shut down the others?
You've got to make him work hard to get to 20, but my goodness, right now, where he's going, he's going to get 40 on you. And, of course, Reynolds is an excellent player. Carlo is doing a great job. So you try to contain him, not let him have a big night, keep around that 20, 25 range, but and try to contain everyone else. But you're right, he's going to get some points. He's just too good of an offensive player. Try to shut him out.
Evans working hard inside, collects his 5th point. And that's Western's lead as we approach 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. George Plaster, Coach Clem Haskins with you. Glad to have you with us on this Sunday afternoon. McCaleb again. Not this time, but an offensive rebound sets them back up, and McNeely drains the three. That young man has 10 points as well. 2-point Western lead with 2 minutes to play in the half. Mendez Valdez trying to turn the corner, and it wasn't that easy.
They do an excellent job on the ball screen. They hedge at it, but showing the two guys, they double team that. So they do an excellent job when they try to come off the top of that ball screen. They hedge at, and they also double it up on that.
Orlando got called on an offensive foul. Boy, you look at the shooting totals you saw a moment ago. New Orleans at 68%, but down two, and Western hasn't exactly been, you know, chopped liver either at 52%. So both teams playing really well on the offensive end.
Both teams are shooting the ball extremely well, like you say, on both ends of the court. They're making good basketball plays. These have been some good basketball plays for both teams. Good penetration here, good kick on the base here, good drive here. Caleb come with the basketball. He's doing a good job of breaking the defense down, but driving, penetrating the gaps, and getting good looks. There's McCaleb again deep in the corner.
One thing about him, he is not bashful to let it fly.
He's not bashful letting it fly, but you know he's an excellent shooter. And
Lee missed on that three, but you know what? If you're on the other end, you're saying take it, because he'll get going.
Yeah, you're holding your breath on him because he can really get it going. Like I say, he's been off, a little bit rusty, but you know he go down at halftime, settle down a little bit, come out in the second half, and perhaps some of those shots will fall.
Darren Horn's got to be thrilled to get Courtney Lee back. You've still got more than a month in the regular season, and so what you're hoping is get him really back to his top form and then get ready for postseason tournament play and NCAA play as well, if that be the case. Adam Howard into the game for Western Kentucky for the final minute of the first half. Reynolds, the third privateer in double figures. And Western's lead is down to one. Very young lineup out on the court right now for Darren Horn in this final minute, not wanting some players to pick up that third. And look at Evans, Howard, and a chance at a three.
That was a nice basketball play by the Topper. Young man threw the ball to the baseline side. Evans did a nice job posting up. He led him to the baseline side. He got it. He made a drop step and dunked it for a nice bucket. That was a very, very good basketball play.
That's Evans' eighth point, and they've all come in the last 2 minutes.
Well, I tell you what, I'm impressed with Evans' free throw. He stepped up and made some nice free throws tonight as well as following up. It's about two or three three-point plays there. So big guy making some free throws.
Difference in game clock and shot clock looks to be about a half a second. So New Orleans likely will play for the final shot of the half, down by four. They get to about 10 seconds, and here they go. McCaleb, the kick out. Reynolds missed on the three, and that's the way the first half is going to come to a close. Entertaining first half. Both teams shot the ball very well. And here at the intermission, Western Kentucky 42, New Orleans 38. This is the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network on Fox College Sports. Well, here in Bowling Green, Western Kentucky, a 4-point lead at the intermission. Here's something you don't get to say very often on the college level at halftime. Four different players are in double figures, and you don't see that very often. Bo McCaleb, who is the fourth leading scorer in the country, has not disappointed anybody. He has 15. And then on Western's end, this young man, Tyrone Brazelton, the junior out of Park Forest, Illinois, 13 points, has really shot the ball very well in leading the Toppers to this four-point lead. When we come back, we'll shift gears, talk some women's college basketball. Stay tuned. Western Kentucky leading by four. Well, as you can see, a lot of activities going on here at halftime on the floor of Diddle Arena. Our guest here at the intermission is the women's basketball coach at Western Kentucky University, Mary Taylor Cowles, joins us. Your team is playing well. Big win yesterday against UNO, so you're a happy camper.
We are pretty happy today, George, and we've continued to improve, and obviously we're not where we want to be yet, but I see some progress, and as long as we can continue to make progress, the coach stays pretty happy.
And I can tell you're a coach because the voice is not 100%.
The voice is awful, but it just kind of comes with the business, I guess, in this time of year.
Tell me a little bit. You all have really shown some improvement in the last month and a half. What's led to that?
Well, I think we have some great leadership, and especially in two of our upperclassmen, Crystal Kelly and Charlotte Marshall. They've just really been good for our basketball team this year, and they continue to lead by example in practice and obviously carry it over to the ball games. And all in all, though, George, we just have a great group of young ladies that are very committed to Western Kentucky University and our women's basketball program, and they want to get better every day we step out on the floor.
For people who have not seen Crystal Kelly, what is it that makes her so special?
Oh, goodness. I don't really think I can sum it into one word. She's extremely powerful, very, very dominating low post player. But this year, what I think has really, really made her so even more valuable, if there's such a thing, is that she's extended her shooting ability out to the three-point range. And she's taken the ball off the dribble a whole lot more. But she's such a complete team player, George. She really cares about winning for this team, and she really cares about her teammates, and she works extremely hard for us every single day.
I'm going to hit you with something you've got no idea is coming.
Okay.
In the past, on the women's scene, most of the attention has gone to the SEC, and deservedly so. They've been a very powerful conference. I see earlier this week a cover story in USA Today's sports section. It involves Rick Insel and MTSU, but it's starting to filter down, isn't it?
Well, it is, and I've said for 2 years now that it's time for people to really step back and take a look at the Sun Belt Conference and our women's basketball teams, because we are a very strong conference. We're currently eighth in the RPI. We're playing a very competitive schedule, not just outside our conference, but inside our conference. Our coaches are great. Our talent level is just improving every year, and we're willing to compete. So, you know, I think, and like I said, George, we've been arguing this for at least 2 years now. It's time that people step up and take a look at Sun Belt Conference women's basketball.
Okay, I'm really going to put you on the spot. I'm going to put you on the committee. In 30 seconds or less, how many teams get in?
From the Sun Belt?
Yep.
Well, I mean, obviously, I think Middle's proven themselves up to this point. I think when I think about can we compete in the Sun Belt, I mean, in the NCAA, I feel like Western Kentucky can. But then there's so many other teams. I mean, you've got Louisiana Lafayette, who came in here last Sunday, and boom. I mean, we saw just how good they were. Arkansas State, Florida International, Arkansas Little Rock, which I think is just tremendous. You still got South Dow that has great talent. And I could go on, and you only gave me 30 seconds. But I hope Western Kentucky's name is in there. Since I've got this interview, I'll take advantage of saying that.
We'll see you in March and see if this turns out to be right. Thanks
okay,
for doing
George,
this.
Thank you.
Mary Taylor Cowles has been our guest. Second half and a few more of the first half highlights. When we come back, Western Kentucky leading by four. And as we take a look at some things that went on in the first half, Coach Clem Haskins rejoins us. Clem, the offenses really got done what they wanted.
Really, yes. You know, both offense played extremely well. They shot the ball well. And the key, though, they executed. They really didn't get impatient. They came down, they worked the basketball, they penetrated. Regardless if it's a man against zone, they showed a lot of patience to get a high percentage shot. That's why they're shooting an excellent percentage at this stage.
We'll take a look at some of the highlights. This was one that I loved. From courtside, you see Tyrone Brazelton's speed, and and the problems that causes a defense.
Right. Anytime you get inside a defense like that, and you got to get some layup, you got to find a way to get the ball inside. What if you pass it inside, if you drive it, it penetrated to the basket, it creates some opportunities to shoot within 1 to 5 feet of that basket. And I like to think, give you big guys a chance to get some offense rebounds. When you shoot long shots, threes, when they're from 15 to 25 feet out, you're going to have long rebounds. And the inside people don't have a chance to get those offense rebounds. And late in the ball game, Walker had a field day because he got some nice looks inside. He got a chance to get inside, get some putbacks and offense rebounds, as well as him and Evans.
So look at those shooting percentages. UNO at 62%. And Clem, is that discouraging for them, the fact that they're over 60 and they're down at the intermission?
Not really. You know, they take a high percentage shot, just Western shooting over 50%. Both teams are playing extremely well, and Western really in this basketball game because they're doing a good job on the offensive board and keeping them. That's what's keeping them in the game.
Western, the 9-rebound edge. You see some of the other statistics that show up in this tough, tight ball game. We expect more of the same in the second half, so stay tuned. Don't pull that dial. 42-38 Western at the intermission. This is the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network on Fox College Sports. It bears some mention. Clem, I was down in New Orleans about 3 weeks ago for the Sugar Bowl, and obviously things are better in that city, but they're certainly not where everybody wants to see them. It's affected the University of New Orleans. They are now using an old practice facility of theirs as their home gym, seats about 1,200, and it's just one of the things that down there they're having to deal with.
Well, they have to deal with it. People have no idea unless you go and visit the city. And once you go in, you just see in New Orleans, but you get on the outskirts, you see the things not what they used to be, and it's so sad yet.
I was amazed at the job that they've done to repair the Superdome. All of you remember the gruesome shots when Hurricane Katrina hit, of the devastation in that, you know, monstrosity of a building. And they have put that thing back together. I went to the LSU Notre Dame Sugar Bowl and was amazed. The Superdome is one of the things that they have used as a source of pride down there. But University of New Orleans struggling through this. Daniel Emerson starting the second half, and it's important that he not pick up a third foul early. McCaleb coast to coast, couldn't get it to fall, and then Emerson draws the foul on McCaleb. McCaleb picking up his second foul of the game.
But I tell you what, that was some tough, aggressive play on both ends. I was crying because I was just watching the action. I love to see that kind of aggressive play. That's why I couldn't say anything. I was speechless there because on the Western end of the court as well as on the New Orleans side, this team is really getting after each other. This is an interesting ball game to watch.
Lee coming off the weave. Even though the shot's not going, I like what I'm seeing. He looks like it's all in the flow.
It's in the flow. You know, those are good shots. He just missed no shot. Those are shots he usually makes.
Harlow, who hasn't missed a shot in about 2 weeks, gets his second tray. And I say that, a perfect 6 of 6 a couple of days ago against Troy, all of them from three-point land. And New Orleans, a chance to take the lead here. And McCaleb had that one swatted away by Courtney Lee. And on the other side, I think it's McCaleb. And if it is, it's his third.
That's his third foul. I tell you what, that's a plus for the top to get him in foul trouble because he's really the one-man wrecking crew right now. He's just taking over his basketball game both ends of the court.
Now, if you're Buzz Williams, you've elected to keep McCaleb in, but you are holding your breath saying, don't get the fourth.
Well, there's some people can play when they get in foul trouble, like to pick up three fouls or pick up two fouls. And some of them just, you got to really take them out because they play not with the head, they play with the heart. You can't play guys like that.
Emerson. Boy, great rotation on that three for Daniel.
Well, he showed you his touch on the outside. You know, this big guy can really shoot the basketball. Tops don't have the inside presence, so they got to play him inside. But he really can shoot the ball on the perimeter. So in the future, you'll see him shoot more jump shots.
Every last point that New Orleans has scored is in their backcourt, which sounds nice. But, boy, it gets tough at times when you've got to have a bucket. Speaking of got to have a bucket, Reynolds snuck inside to get his 12th point. And on the other end, Evans, as quick as you could say, get back down the court. Western leads by four.
Well, he just beat his man down the court. He just turned out, ran the big guy down the court. Solomon got to get back. At that time, that was a smart play by the guard, and also a great job of Evan just outrunning his man.
Buzz Williams had a word or two for Suleiman, who was a little slow getting back there. I'm not sure we can repeat what he had to say. McNeely, long three. And that one goes against New Orleans, and I think it's Suleiman picking up his second.
You know, he got caught in in between that time. Emerson was pushing Suleiman.
He got a big old sandwich.
He got a sandwich job that time, and Suleiman wound up pushing Evan, so that's an unfortunate call. But, again, that's been aggressive basketball.
He was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
That's correct.
Western up four. Lee spots up, misses the three. I'm going to say it again, though. I like the way he's moving, even though he's not doing a ton of scoring. Reynolds misses inside. It'll go to Western Kentucky. And I'm going to suspect here, Clem, that Darren Horn knew going in this was probably not going to be one of Courtney Lee's 25-point games, but it's just great to get him back in the flow.
It's great to get him back in the flow of things, you know. Those shots he's missing now, we all know they will fall sooner or later. But it's good to get him back in the flow of things and get his feet wet again. There's another good shot here by Emerson.
Well, I'll tell you what. He is showing great rotation, nice form on a pair of threes. Western's biggest lead of the game at seven, about 4 minutes into the second half.
Those two really nice look by Emerson right there. Step outside and hit those jump shots. That really helps you when you drop those threes like that.
New Orleans has done nothing on this possession. Shot clock's already down to seven.
They're not hurting top right now. Something driven around the perimeter.
McNeely.
Oh,
got the roll.
Got now, a nice bounce that time.
There was a lot of dribbling with very little purpose, and he just kind of stepped back and said, so what? Brazelton fouled by Reynolds. Will take a timeout. 15:43 to play in the game. It's still anybody's contest. Western, a four-point lead on the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network. Well, there is one of the youngest of the Topper fans looking on today from Diddle Arena. Jeremy Evans with the inside bucket. And then from long range, Daniel Emerson with great form.
Great form, great rotation on the basketball. When you see guys shoot with that great touch, like to step on two-throw jumper. Great shot.
Daniel, 2-for-2 today from long range. How do you feel if you're New Orleans? You're 62% from the field. It's 16 of 28, and yet you're down four. Emerson again. That one was a little bit off.
A little bit off, but, you know, he hit two in a row, so you got to take that third, so nothing wrong with that. You have to miss it, but, you know, it was a good look.
Boy, they come out on the double team and maybe came a little too strong.
A little too aggressive at times.
They're going with Ty Rogers. That is Ty's third. First team foul of the half.
Here's an interesting matchup here. Here's McAllen against Lee here. So it should be fun to watch this here. This is a good. Oh. Big guys are jumping out, but they're not moving their feet. They're going out and really trying to hold a guy. They're not doing a good job of really keeping that pocket by moving their feet. They're not sliding their feet when they come out there. And I call it a hedge or show on that ball screen.
And when McCaleb turns the corner, you better do it in a hurry.
You got to do it in a hurry. They're trying to keep him in the pocket. Don't want him to turn the corner, and that's why Coach Horn's got him jumping the ball screen right there, doubling up. And that's smart. That's good coaching there. And good ball, good strategy. Strategy by the coach.
McCaleb stops and pops. And it'll stay with the Privateers. Looked like Lee or Brazelton may have touched it. Harlow, long three, finally missed one. And that one will stay. with New Orleans. So a frustrating possession if you're Western, because twice they haven't been able to get the rebound.
No, the big guy being in there really creating some problem for him, because that time got a deflection and that could have went either way, but they got the call on that one.
Backdoor cut, McCaleb, offensive foul. And I know what New Orleans is going to argue, that he was too close to the bucket to call that. Let's see. Boy, that is tight.
That's tight, and that's why I like to see that dotted line put in. We say it every game. That way you take it out of the official's hand right there. It's NBA, you would know if it would be a block or a charge because of the dotted line.
And here's the bigger problem. It's the fourth foul on McCaleb, and so he is going to have to sit some significant minutes in this game. Brazelton takes advantage.
No, that was right there the big-time play, and he dunks the ball. That was an unbelievable little fella going there and dunk it over a 6'9 guy. What a play.
Trust me when I tell you we're likely to see that one again.
It's a big-time play.
As soon as we get a chance. That one taken away. Orlando ahead to Siakam, who jams. It had been kind of quiet, and suddenly that has changed.
I'd say anytime you get a dunk like that, it'll wake up the crowd. They love to see a dunk from the young people, as well as the old people. This is an unbelievable dunk here by a little fella. You know, that's a little fella guard, you know, in that 5'10, 5'11 range, to come around there and dunk that basketball. And here's a nice pass here, tall by Mendez, Vazdez over to Siakam. He takes it home.
Now, Brazelton is 5'11, and he didn't look like he had any trouble whatsoever. Siakam at 6'7", you expect him to be able to flush it.
Well, that's why I've always been impressed. With a big guy, he should be able to dunk the basketball. If he's 6'5 plus, you know, 6'3", 6'4". But little guys like that, those 5'9", those 6-foot guys, really, to me, is impressive. This is a big-time dunk here by a little guy. And little guy, I mean a guy 5'9", 5'10", 5'11", like Brazelton. That was a big, big-time move and a great finish.
So if you're on Western side, you want this burst of energy to continue, but on the New Orleans front, now they're having to do it without their big gun. McCaleb picking up his fourth foul. How prepared are they to play without him?
Well, I tell you what, Wade Quaylo's playing, and a guy, McNeely and Reynolds, they're scoring, so they have a chance just to end the basketball game. If they don't get in an up-tempo game, come down here, so a little more pressure on offense in the court and not let the top get behind like they have in the last 2 or 3 minutes. They can stay in the ball game and give McCaleb a chance to get back in the ball game in the last 4 or 5 minutes.
This is the danger time for the Privateers, because they play without their big star. And you know what Buzz Williams is saying in that huddle is, keep us close enough that when we do put him back in, he can make a difference.
He can make a difference. That's all you want to do right now, just stay close. Within 6 to 8 points, you know, 1 or 2 possessions, and you have a chance.
Now, on Darren Horn's side, it's just the opposite. They want to hit them with a Mack truck before McCaleb gets back in there.
Right. They want to keep applying the pressure, force some more turnovers, try to get a few more points and a bigger lead.
A lot of the pressure falls on this guy, McNeely, and he answers the bell for his 15th point.
So he can really score. Anytime a guy of guys like that can score, you know, you don't have to worry about it. He can score points.
Siakam, one step too many. Turnover goes the other way. Now, this is interesting. McCaleb, with his four fouls, is coming back in, and I'm going to interpret that as he sold his coach on the, I can stay out of the fifth.
I can stay out of foul trouble. We're going to see here 13 minutes and 45 seconds, almost 14 minutes to go. We'll see what's going to happen, see how long we can play by picking up at fifth.
The question I'm going to ask is, if he has to play on the defensive end, do you go right after him?
You should go right after him, yes. Yes, you got to design a player play to go right after him. Want to get on the offense end of court. I mean the top is on offense.
There's McCaleb. He pulls up from 15 and scores.
That's why they put him back in the ball game, you know, and it's a 4-point game.
Now the question is, can he play on the other end with those four? Mendez Valdez. Well, they went right after him.
They went right after him, you know what I'm talking about. But that was a good defense on his part, though. His hand up, the guy just made a tough shot. Mendez Valdez made a big-time three there, but he was in the right position, his hand up. You got to give credit to the offensive player.
Western's lead at 7. A little more than 7 minutes gone by here in the second half. McCaleb to the baseline again. I tell you what, he loves the baseline jumper. He's got 19, but Joyner beat everybody back on the other end. That's the second or third time today that New Orleans has fallen asleep after a made field goal.
Well, I tell you, that's what the top's going transition. They're getting the ball in quick and throwing it over top of their defense. That's what you want to do, advance that ball. And when guys slow, getting back in transition. Top has been really smart in that, getting the ball over the top of the defense.
McCaleb make that Parlow out of the corner. Brazelton clears. Brazelton starts the drive and got held up in the lane, and we're going to have a timeout. It comes with 11:51 to play in the game. Western's lead is 7 on the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network. Ago when Bo McCaleb picked up his fourth foul for New Orleans, I turned to Clem Haskins and I said, okay, if he's going to stay in the game, do you go right after him? Well, take a look at the answer.
Well, he went right after him, but you know, hey, we made a big three over top of him, you know, but it was good defense on his part, his hands up. But also, he answered the call. He came in and hit 2 big buckets for them. I tell you what, he's hit 2 out of 3 shots so far, returned the game. The fullest game, keep within striking distance.
You know, the other thought that crossed my mind is that Buzz Williams almost admitted when he let McCaleb stay in with 4, we can't win without you.
We can't win without you. That's right. They're going to need him. They're going to need him, no doubt about that. But you got to be smart. Because they're really playing well without him, though. They got some scores. And Reynolds and McNeil, Parlow, they can really score.
Brazelton. They get it down low to Siakam. They tried the give and go, and Joyner made a good save, had it rejected, and then may have fouled in frustration. Joyner's first, and that is 3 team fouls in the half against Western.
Western's applying full court pressure. They still want an up-tempo game. Here comes a little running jump. They double it here, almost forced a turnover.
And the jump ball, possession arrow goes to New Orleans.
That was a good pressure by the top. They run a little running jump and went up doubling the basketball and forced a jump ball. And, of course, New Orleans keeps the possession.
So with that possession arrow, the shot clock does not change. It's already down to 17. McNeely found a man low, and Suleiman gets his first field goal to cut the lead to 5. Brazelton, oh, nice feed. Siakam tried to power it up there. Mendez Valdez had that one swatted, and it did. Reynolds did touch the sideline, so it'll be Western's ball.
Western ball, but great defense play by Solomon.
Suleiman.
Oh,
are you ready to spell that?
No, not correct. I can't pronounce it. I don't spell it. But Suleiman did a nice job of blocking that shot there, you know, keeping the ball from scoring. Great defense play on their part.
I'm going to give you 3 A's, and then you're going to have to do the rest. There are 3 A's.
I'll tell you what, he's a really good defensive player in there.
Good drive. Ashrunge Suleiman. The miss, McNeely running. And he pulls up, missed from about 14. Mendez Valdez tried to go into the land of the Giants and then fouled to pick up what is his 4th.
Getting it out of control right now. They're not coming down and setting up and playing with their head. They're playing a lot of control. And Mendez Valdez got out of control that time and really threw up a bad shot. And and turned the ball over. So this is not really a heady play on the Thomas part in the last minute or so.
That stat you saw a moment ago is Darren Horn's willingness to play a lot of folks, and especially early in the season. Playing all those folks has shown up today, 16-2 advantage on the bench.
The bench has been a key so far. Like you say, you know, the Toppers, they play a lot of guys, and their bench play has been really excellent here to keep them in this basketball game. We've got so far they got a 5-point lead, but it's anybody's game. It's 10 minutes to go, so it's anyone's game at this time.
New Orleans with a fresh 35 as we resume.
Walker's back in the basketball game. He turned this game around in the first half. You see here, he's coming off again, almost knocked it loose. And he was one of the keys of the game that turned around in the first half.
McCaleb, boy, he's strong upper body as well. He's got 21, and the lead is down to 3. Brazelton misfired that time on the 3. New Orleans with a chance to get even closer. McCaleb was cherry picking. He's got 23, and at least for the moment, Clem, the decision to keep him in the game is paying a huge dividend.
It's paying a huge dividend. He's got at least 4 buckets out of the last 5-6 shots he's taken here, and it's really paying dividends. You know, that time he got behind the defense here and they found him over the top. Top didn't do a good job of getting back on defense, and they got a layup. But, you know, the thing is about him, he was so under control. He's going down the court. He slowed down just enough to make the bucket, you know, let the guy hit him and make the shot. He plays like a pro, you know. And this young man, I feel like, has a chance to be a pro down the road. Excellent NBA prospect.
Now, let me ask you this question. If you're Buzz Williams and you've got the lead back within one, do you consider sitting him for a minute or two?
Well, number one, you may want to sit him for give him a chance to blow at the team. But he's on a roll right now, and he's playing heady basketball. And, you know, again, you got to know your players. I really don't know. But I would probably take him out, and I think Coach going to take him out this stage and give him three or four minute blow here. And because the game is in hand right now. They're within 1 point. Anything can happen. So this is good coaching move on their part.
What does it say that they're listening to me?
You're doing a great job. You should.
It's not a good sign for the coaching profession, is it?
Not really.
You said that way too quick. Rogers. It says something seriously bad about the coaching profession. Shot clock's down to 12. Siakam. Looked like he was going to pull the trigger on it. Rogers does. And New Orleans. They were down 7 a few moments ago. And now, on this possession, a chance to take the lead. Tough double team trap. Reynolds did a good job, and then Slaughter knocked it out of bounds. The traps have come very close to causing trouble.
They're doing a good job of trapping, but they're going to have to rotate down because that guy, they swing that ball real quick, one pass out of that trap, and they're going to have a layup. And that concerned me there. If they ever get the ball, they started moving it, recognize that, and make that one quick pass, and guy inside can wind up getting a layup. But they're doing a good job of trapping the ball. You're correct.
Shot clock's down to 12, and Reynolds realizes that and starts a drive. May have gotten away with a travel, and the ball is New Orleans, and they will have only 4 on the shot clock, and Clem, that kind of narrows the possibilities here.
Well, it's almost a catch, not quite a catch and shoot. You got to gather yourself and shoot the jump shot because they throw a lob because AJ's there for the steal.
Suleiman didn't look like he was expecting it. Slaughter from 15. McCaleb got fouled by Rogers, and that's Ty's 4th.
Well, Ty made his, he whacked him on the arm. He realized he made a bad decision to foul that guy, so that was not a smart play. Foul on Ty Rogers' part, but the ball has already been rebounded by the defensive player.
So they sat McCaleb with the 4 fouls for about a minute, and then Buzz Williams got him back in. Darren Horn will get Rogers out with his 4 fouls and put Courtney Lee into the game. Lee playing for the first time in about 3 weeks. He has shown some rust. Yes, the 5 points doesn't look like Courtney Lee, but he's moving very well. McCaleb got clobbered. when he tried to throw it back in, but he's up and apparently moving okay. Western with the ball up one in a tough, tight game here at Diddle Arena. Brazelton. Well, I tell you what, Clem, he shoots the ball off the wrong foot as good as anybody I've seen.
Well, you're right. He's one of those guys, he's hard to deal with because, you know, he's quick. He can get to the basket on you. And also, he can pull up, shoot a jump shot as well as the three. So, you know, he's a clever ball handler and a very, very good player.
Those of you who are saying, oh, that's not that big a deal, go try it. Go out on a basketball court, even with nobody guarding you, and try that drive and then shoot it off the wrong foot. Well, I did all that bragging and I jinxed it. Slaughter. He kind of got slaughtered on the way up, and the crowd letting the officials know it.
Right. They hit him a little bit, but I think the big guy had all ball that time. You know, the second guy may put a little body on him, but the big guy had ball all the way at the top, I believe.
Yep.
The second guy may have bumped him a little bit with the body. But the big fella's playing big in there.
McNeely had the block for UNO. Lee from 12 didn't get the roll, but again, movement looks really good, and that's the encouraging part of what we're seeing out of Courtney Lee. We'll be getting a dead ball timeout in a moment. There's a five call. Too much dribbling by Reynolds, doing absolutely nothing. Timeout with 7:49 to play. It is a tough, tight ball game. Western leads it by one. These folks know it's a tough, tight ball game. Western Kentucky up by only one. Clem, it's little things, especially on the road, that can get you beat. We see McCaleb hit the jumper, but look, not a whole lot of get back on defense, and it cost him.
It cost him here. You know, they didn't get back. It's not necessarily McCaleb fault here. It's a guard fault here. The point guard should be back there, protect the basket in that situation. So they do a good job. But also, we've been burnt both ways. You know, top have been burnt, then getting back as well. So both teams have not done a good job overall getting back and stopping the break.
We're now in crunch time, if you will, down to 7:40. In a conference game with two of the better Sun Belt Conference teams in the league. Western at 6-2. New Orleans in the Western side of it at 5-3. Privateers, their second chance to take the lead the first time down. They got a five call. 5 second violation. Shot clock's down to 10. They haven't done a whole lot on this possession at all. Reynolds trying to fight around Evans. It's down to two. It's rejected inside. Shot clock violation. Clem, I thought they took way too much time doing nothing.
Well, way too much time getting into the play that time. Did a wonderful job there on defense. Got to give the top a lot of credit there on defense. Really shutting them down that time. And also inside people protecting the bucket, blocking that shot, and come up with the big rebound.
Western Kentucky could use a bucket. Courtney Lee, 2 of 15, but I'm going to say it again. I know people are going to get fixed on that stat. To me, that's not the important thing. The important thing, he's out there. He'll start hitting that shot.
Yeah, he's competing hard. You know what I'm talking about? He just is valuable on the defense end. I've said so many times, his offense. His defense is excellent. Playing hard, working hard. But see, the guys that can't make shots are liability some nights. You know, his offense has been excellent. Defense has been excellent.
Brazelton, I think, got caught on the floor. Nope, I'm wrong about that. Courtney Lee picks up his third, and that is 16 fouls against Western Kentucky.
They're doing a good job running some baseline screens for the players that are coming off here, and Courtney's guarding a little bit too tight.
Well, they got inside. McCaleb somehow wedged his way to the bucket. He has 25, and New Orleans is up one, and Lee says, I'm feeling a lot better.
That's a nice, tough, hard drive, hard, great finish there by Lee. That's what you're supposed to do when you're a big-time player, take that ball to the rack and finish. That's what he did on that drive.
He split a pair of defenders to get his seventh point.
But he's coming back. He's guarding the great offensive players. See, McCaleb here, And that's what I like to see, you know. A lot of guys won't take that challenge, boy, and meet it. And Lee's meeting it tonight here because he's got his hands full trying to guard him.
Reynolds got bumped by Evans. Jeremy picking up his second, and so now UNO will be in the bonus.
The fans going to be in for a treat here in this round. 5 minutes, almost 6 minutes to go, 5 minutes and 45 seconds to go. And the team step up and make these free throws is going to be the team going to win this basketball game because it's going to be one or two possessions going to be the difference in this ball game.
McCaleb goes back out of the game with his four fouls. They're not going to risk him on the defensive end when they can get away with it. Reynolds missed it, and it goes off of Hippolito, who just checked in a moment ago. So Western up one will have the ball.
They're very fortunate to be up one on that right there. They didn't do a good job of holding their position. They almost got a piece of that ball, meaning New Orleans almost got the offensive rebound. So they got to do a good job of putting their body to maintain that contact.
Get a holding call on, I think, McNeely, and he didn't like that at all, did he?
No, he didn't like that at all, but that's when them go either way. Just very, very fortunate Courtney Lee didn't get a push-off on that, but he was holding. It was kind of a late call, I thought. I thought at the end, Courtney Lee pushed him off, but I guess the referee was slow by blowing that whistle.
Western on the year at 72% from the line, which is very good. In fact, both of these teams shoot free throws well. New Orleans right around 70%. Some people think it's a lost art, but it will win and lose a lot of tight conference games.
Like we talked about, free throws is really, really critical right now. Just all you do at home, keep your stats on those free throws. Who make these free throws gonna come out winning this game here because every possession is critical.
Lee goes out. Ty Rogers with his four fouls is in. McCaleb with his four fouls is back in. Kind of a chess match right now as both coaches try to juggle through some foul difficulties.
This is when you're coaching, you earn your keep right here. You earn your money, boy, when you make the right calls here.
Ooh. Reynolds was able to turn the corner, and it took a lot of work to do it. And then McNeely off the glass. He has 17. And the lead is back down to one.
That's why you can play. So you got McNeely, you got Reynolds. Those guys can still make shots. And when you have guys like that can score, you still can win without your top gun playing a lot of minutes. Because McCaleb's back on the court with him now anyway.
McCaleb has been able to play almost 10 minutes with the four fouls. Rogers for three. And he gets his own rebound. And a new 35. Emerson tried to post. Great feed to Mendez Valdez.
Great feed, a great finish by Mendez Valdez. You're right. That's an excellent pass. Doesn't have his eyes in the back of his head there. Emerson came up with a great post feed.
It went from a disaster to brilliance in about 0.3 seconds. McCaleb split the defense. What a move. That was some Allen Iverson right there.
Those are great moves right there. That's what I'm saying about you. Talking about a guy that's going to be a great, he's a great college player, but he's going to be a great player to the next level. He just knows how to play and things like that. You can't coach that and teach that. That's just great instincts and great basketball savvy.
Reynolds got caught from behind for his second foul. McCaleb, by the way, with a game high 27. We've got a timeout. It looks like we're going to the wire. Tough, tight ball game here in Bowling Green. Well, they're having fun, but they're also sweating some bullets right now because this is a tough, tight one that may well go right to the wire. Look at this play. Talk about a heady play by Daniel Emerson.
On the seat of his pants, he made this play. That's a great play right there. You know what I mean? Talking about the highlights tonight. You turn on the ESPN, whatever. That ought to be on a highlight right there. Make a play like that on the seat of your pants. I call it quarter awareness. Wear where your man at, your teammates at. Particularly lead to from that pass to a bucket. Great, great play by Emerson.
That'd be an easy place to panic.
Right. Easy place to panic. That's right.
New Orleans going into the teeth of Big Red Country. He's got a big mouth.
Brazelton, free throw line.
Then again, so do I.
Yes.
Brazelton earns the bonus, his 16th point.
These free throws are critical. 3 minutes, 46 seconds ago. There's two more by the Thompson. Brazen have been really a clutch player for the Thompson the last few weeks.
A very complete game. 3-point lead. For Western Kentucky, they are all big trips from here on in. Clem, one of the things I've noticed, Western has made them work so hard to get around the screens. Now that time, Suleiman hits from about 12, but when they've hedged the screens, they have really made New Orleans work hard.
Made them work hard, you know what I'm talking about, but they've really shown a lot of patience here too, you know. Still just a 1-point ball game, and you know, the top of both teams, I just like both teams where they're playing, and you got to give them both credit. They're doing a great job on both ends of the court of making each other work hard to get shots.
Shot clock's at 15. Emerson, when he puts it on the floor, New Orleans is trying to attack him, and that time they were able to make the defensive play. Privateers, a chance to take the lead again.
In the post there, when people collapse like that, you don't get but one good bounce, two max, and you can't play with it now. You got to one hard dribble and shoot it or pass it.
McCaleb tried to split the defense. That time, Brazelton got his hands on the ball and kept him there. Strong play, possession arrow to Western.
Well, that was a good play by Brazelton. Get over and help, and he went to spin. He spinned right back into him. He did an excellent job of stopping the ball and getting the jump ball.
He may be the most important player today on this court. Orlando Mendez Valdez, that is a big two. Foot
big
on the
two,
line.
Big two, big time play here. Good Brazelton set him up. An excellent jump shot. Came off just a ball screen there, and young man found him and he hit a nice bucket.
Orlando with nine as we approach 2 minutes to play. There's the give and go, and McCaleb got his own rebound. I'll tell you what I'm impressed with, Clem. Among other things, when a teammate gets in trouble, he cuts to the bucket.
You know, he's such a heady basketball player. You know what I'm talking about? He just knows to go to the open spot. Most guys run away from the basketball. He understands the pass lane. He understands when to cut, how to cut. That was a nice diagonal cut that time to get to the basket until a young man found him for a pass, and also he drew a foul.
The hand is for Orlando Mendez Valdez. He fouls out, having scored nine, and they get Courtney Lee back into the game for the final 152.
Well, they're going to miss him because the guy could capable of making some jump shot. Mendez Valdez has really shot the ball extremely well for the Toppers last three games. Now, with Courtney having an off night, they need his stroke out there. Now, if Roger got to step up and hit a bucket, they'd be okay.
Got one for you here. That was McCaleb's 161st free throw of the year attempted. His team has attempted 401, so he shot 40% of their free throws.
Well, it's amazing. I'd say he'd have to be, if he's not the leading free throw shooter in the country, he's got to be up in the top five without a doubt, attempts in the country. That tells you getting to the free throw line a lot.
Evans missed from 15, and here comes New Orleans. They're down two, a chance to tie or take the lead.
Well, it tells you who gets the rebound. See, the best player, he also gets the rebound for him. Pull up, shoot the jump shot. That's Courtney Lee for Western. He's a cost for them. He gets the rebound.
That was a big miss right there. Lee into the lane, lays it up, lays it in.
Now, that's what it's all about there. You can see this is a big-time player here. He gets it up, he gets the rebound, he takes it down the court, his team needs 2 points. He drives to his left with his weak hand and gets a big-time bucket. He comes back down here and guard the best offensive player.
Two-possession game with under a minute to play. A lot of the crowd standing here. Diddlerina Parlo, long three.
Well, he's got ice water in his veins. I tell you what, he jumped up and hit that three over Evan. Evan reached from here to China, and he makes a nice three.
He is 9 of his last 10 from three-point territory in a two-game span. And for New Orleans, that was just what the doctor ordered. Take a look at this from high above.
High above, good defense. You know, he gets out and hit it. He just hit nothing but net. That's a big-time three. This young man really can shoot it. That's why this team's a very, very good ball club, a scary team to play. That's why on the road, we said so many times, they're 3-1. And also, the only game they lost by 2 points, and they had a chance to be 4-0 on the road, and that's amazing. Here's a big-time drive here, but one of the premier players in the country, Courtney Lee, had an off-night shooting the basketball here, and now he decided to take the ball to the rack, which is the basket, and he gets 2 points.
Okay, Clem, now, if you're Darren Horn, the options, Lee and Brazelton in some order?
Without a doubt, he's got to be involved. You know, Brazelton's got to be involved taking this ball to the basket here when time runs down. Also, maybe Lee one drive to the basket. But if you want to look at an open jump shot, it has to be Roger. If he gets a good open look, wide open shot, he's capable of knocking down a bucket.
Western by one. As you see up top, shot clock's down to 22. They're going to milk this thing down probably to around 10 seconds and then get going. Lee guarded by McNeely. Starts his drive, gets into the lane, and got the roll.
He got the bounce that time, you know. When you have big, strong guys like that, he's going to get a shot off. You just hope he can make the shot, get it up there soft, and get a chance to tip it in. And that's why I like to get in close to take a shot like that. If he missed that shot, you got a chance with Evan, where he can reach, and a chance to get an offensive rebound. Clint, he gets inside. It's about a 6-8 foot shot here. And here's a good shot here. Now, if you miss this shot, you got a chance. There's Roger getting there. You got Emerson. You got to tip it in if you miss a shot like that.
Hey, that's a soft touch shooter's roll because it was not online.
It was not online, but he got a nice bounce. You're right, but he laid up soft. And that's what I like to have those big guys, my guys. I tell them, if you want to score, get to the offensive board right there. All I ask guys, like a Roger, anyone shooting them all, like Lee, is lay it up soft, give my big guy a chance to tip it in. That time, he makes a shot, but if he misses it, Emerson had a chance to tip it in with Roger as well as Evan.
If you're New Orleans, don't you have the option here of settling for the two rather than the three?
Well, you got a chance to go base to base and get a quick two. Now you got a chance to foul, make them try to earn two, and you still got a chance to come back and win the game with a three or tie the game. So right now you don't have to settle for the three. You can drive it balls to the basket and try to get a quick two. And that's what the top's got to be worried about. You can't unnecessarily, because the game is not over. They can score here in 1 to 2 seconds, and this ball game is still 16, 17 seconds to go as anybody ball game with a one-point game if they get a two.
Well, this is where the coaches earn their money. Darren Horn on the Western side drawing up perhaps something different. And Buzz Williams on the New Orleans side may have just simply wanted a look at what Western was doing.
He wanted to look at there from the standpoint of New Orleans. He wanted to see what Western going to do. Now, Western should come back and back off. I would not get out here and let the ball go over my head. Western need to keep the ball in front of them and buy some time, and they take some time off the clock. You don't want to come out here and be over-aggressive and let the defense get behind them, because these guards can go 94 feet or 94 feet, meaning score. So they can go base to base and score, but driving around you. So, and in this game here, they can do it within 1 to 5 seconds. So, you know, right now you don't want that to happen. So I would get back and back off and really, you know, fake and drop, and then make sure to keep the ball in front of them.
Well, this is what you love about basketball in January and February. When you get into conference play, a lot of games get decided like this. Down to the last minute or two, the team that makes one play ends up winning the game, the team that hits the free throws, the little things that oftentimes don't necessarily show up in the box score.
Now, this is smart on coach's part. Now, he decided to do that. He backed off. So you don't want to get up and let these people get behind you. You got to keep the ball in front of you if you possibly can. But these guys are too quick, too good with the basketball, and let them turn the corner.
Now they may have to shoot the three. Game clock's down to 9. Carlo for the tie. It's offline. Western's going to win. Boy, you just kept waiting to see if they could get anything better. Clem, Western's defense, when it mattered, really did a good job.
They stepped up big time. That last possession, they played as well as you can play it. They really stepped up big time, and Coach Horn came out of timeout. He really had them well prepared. He backed them off, and I don't always tell them, don't let them turn the corner for a quick two, and also when the clock get down, don't let them shoot that three. And they pull back out and really do a great job defending the three-point as well.
Western wins it 73-70 here in Bowling Green. Let's take a final look at one of the shots that helped win it. Courtney Lee to the bucket.
Courtney, tremendous drive, you know, to the back of the, when he really needed, when he really counted. His defense was solid throughout tonight. Never different in the ball game. He did a tremendous job on the defense end.
Courtney taking another one. In fact, it's the same one as we see a different angle on it. For the record, Western goes to 15-6 on the year, 7-2 in the Sun Belt. New Orleans, 9-11 in Buzz Williams' first year, and 5-4 on the Sun Belt Conference Western Division side. Clem, real quickly, some final thoughts.
Well, it's a very, very good game. Both team had a chance to win the game. Western just held on to win it at the end.
We want to thank all of you for joining us on Championship Sunday. For Clem Haskins and for our entire crew, this is George Plaster. Again, the final, Western wins it, 73-70. You've been watching the Hilltopper Sports Satellite Network.